Hi everyone, this is Lexi Tucker and I am the Associate Editor with LCT Magazine. I am here today with Mr. Ken Carter of Aadvanced Limousine in Indianapolis, Indiana. So Ken, if you could please tell a little bit about your business.
So Lex, first let me say thanks for the opportunity to chat with you. I always find your content and your posts and things like that interesting. So
thank you.
I'm excited to have this opportunity. So I'm a partner of Aadvanced Limousines. We're based in Indianapolis, Indiana. We started the company 15 years ago with my little sister. Kind of a different scenario. Most folks that I've found in the industry typically start with a sedan or an executive type vehicle. Mm-hmm. We kind of went about it what I think is I would call the backwards way. We started with a stretch limousine. We didn't even start with a small stretch. We started with a 14-passenger
stretch.
Wow. So. We kind of got in the industry a little differently, and so, you know, that's allowed us to grow over 15 years and be able to serve a wide variety of market
for
verticals.
Sure. Absolutely. Well, that being said, can we talk maybe a little bit about some of the various verticals you're starting to get involved in?
So our fleet's so diverse that we can offer something for everyone. I got irritated by telling people no. Mm-hmm. So we, you know, shortly after having starting with a 14-passenger stretch, shortly after that, we went to a 10. Then we went to a 22.
Wow, that's such a...
Well, because we found that we were missing a good portion of wedding parties.
Right.
By the time you had 8 bridesmaids, 8 groomsmen, bride and groom, maybe a photographer, you're at 20 people real easy. Mm-hmm. So we got into the 22-passenger, and then that opened up doors for more group-type work, things like that.
Sure.
Then we started attending some LCT shows, and we got into the affiliate market, and we started with the executive type options, sedans, SUVs, that sort of stuff. So I think our most recent purchase was an actual limo coach. So we haven't had one in a while. We had one many years ago, but we've never had one like we've got now. We've got a new Gretsch limo coach. So
nice.
Yeah, it's pretty awesome.
Yeah. And you mentioned that you actually started the company with your little sister. Can you kind of maybe tell me a little bit about the day-to-day dynamics, what kind of works really well, and some things that you guys have had to work to make work?
Her office is at one end of the hall, and mine's at the opposite.
That might help.
No, I'm kidding. actually, we complement each other. She's the reason we have money. I'm the reason we have customers.
Oh.
So she's over the back end, the back office type stuff. Typically, she's not forward facing, and I'm kind of opposite. I'm normally the one that's forward facing. I oversee a lot of the operations type stuff. Our company is in a unique situation because we employ so many family members.
Mm.
We actually have 7.
No way.
7 family members on team. And not by design, mm-hmm. pretty much by accident. But it creates a dynamic workplace with a lot of dedication.
Sure.
A lot of ownership skills that you typically don't find, and the ability to have a little flexibility. You know, if you needed somebody to stay late, they understand the importance
right.
of what it is, where an employee may say, no, I'm not really available or something like that. So.
Sure, I can definitely see that.
But it comes with its challenges also.
I'm sure.
Yeah.
And then I know that you and I have talked in the past a lot about technology and kind of the role it plays in your company. How about we talk a little bit about some of the things that you've adopted within the last year and how you think it's going to kind of advance your company, no pun intended, into the future?
Oh, wow. So that's a great proponent. We're very tech heavy. I love technology. I embrace it. I try to leverage it. It allows us to be able to scale and streamline our business without adding extra responsibilities or tasks on our team.
Mm-hmm.
It allows us to accomplish a lot more and provide a better experience for the customer. One of those is we just recently, maybe about six or eight weeks ago, we implemented post-ride surveys.
Oh, okay.
So we're actually surveying the customer shortly after they get out of the vehicle. It provides us great feedback on what we did right, where we could improve. And it's a great motivational tool to keep our team in alignment with our culture because I share that information with them.
Sure. Yeah, I'm sure having that immediate feedback especially is something that you can immediately implement in everything you do.
Yeah, and it's automated. So we're leveraging a technology piece for that, and it's automated. So it automatically goes to the customer. The customer is, you know, I'd say we're getting an 80% return on those.
Wow.
Maybe, and probably in between a 70 and 80% return.
That's excellent.
So it's providing great, valuable feedback. The most important thing I think that I enjoy is being able to measure the success of the deliverability of our team.
Sure.
So being able to know, hey, we really knocked it out of the park, or hey, we better review this and see if we can't provide a better experience or improve here or there.
Sure.
And we're getting many, 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 many more five stars than we are lower. So it's working out very well.
Excellent to know. Well, thank you so much for joining me today, Ken. I really appreciate it.
I'm excited for the opportunity. Thanks, Lex. I hope you have a great day.
You as well.